biodiversity register, people biodiversity register innovates its way to the Convention on Biodiversity, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, 1992. And this has got the goal to produce sovereignty over the bioresources and conservation of biodiversity and equal distribution of benefits. And in complete to that, India passed its Biodiversity Act in 2002, which has established three level agencies of PBR. National Biodiversity Authority at the national level, State Biodiversity Board at the state, and the local level is Biological Biodiversity Management Committee at the Gram Panchayat level, that is very grassroots level. People Biodiversity Register is of the people, by the people, and for the people. It has got two aspects of getting the knowledge freehand, less structured information organized by the community members, and more structured information put together by group involving teachers, students, and common members. Objectives of this People Biodiversity Register is the conservation of bioresources, sustainable use of bioresources, and also the distribution of equal benefits shared to the local body. This is about the Bidar, where it is located in the plain Deccan Central Plateau and in Karnataka. And it has got 5,448 square kilometers of this one. Its elevation is 582.610 meters, and the average maximum temperature ranges from 38 degrees centigrade to 42, and average rainfall 847 millimeter with humidity 56 to 77%. And biodiversity register has got the many steps of this one. This is a very tedious, laborious work, and this starts with the familiarizing the biodiversity act to the rural people. This is very important, and driving their confidence in the process of that is the preparation of a biodiversity register are the first steps. So people are to be made aware of that what is the Biodiversity Act and what is the role of the people. Unless the people get confidence into that, they won't pour their knowledge, and the knowledge which they pour only will be helpful for the complete treaty, that is the documentation. And for that one, we make different delineation users groups. In that we make out, that is the user groups are divided into two, that some groups are directly depending upon biodiversity and some groups are indirectly depending upon biodiversity, such as agriculturists, horticulturists, poultry people, dairy farm people, and water collectors, fuel collectors. These are directly depending upon, and other community people are indirectly depending upon the biodiversity. So then the documentation of their knowledge is done. And this is not four components. One is the people scape, second is the landscape, third is the waterscape, and fourth is the life scape. Life scape covers entire the biodiversity present in that area is to be documented with the help of the people, local people. And my result is shows that the traditional knowledge existing on the herbal medicine is that they say that they are curing from common diseases to the fatal diseases like cancer, diabetes, leukorrhea, menorrhagia, and jaundice, piles, fever, cough, cold, lymphadenitis, tuberculosis, skin diseases, snake bite, dog bite, scorpion bite, bone fracture, stomach pain, memory, power, increased ejaculation, arthritis, paralysis, migraine, sterility, malnutrition, asthma. Not only that, they are also treating the hydrocyanic acid poisoning, bacterial diseases, and bone fracture, hemorrhagic septicemia, corneal opacity. These are the treated by the local herbal people, as they say. And they use the number of the medicinal plants, and about 200 medicinal plants are documented, and which out of that 122 medicinal plants are used by the local people. And I have found out the status of these medicinal plants, and these plants, about more than 20 to 23 plants are found to be under threat, and these are Hemidesticity, Indica, Tylophora, Gymnema, Cisalpinia, Leptuca, Acanthosperma, Biophytum, and Tenospora, Cochlus insutus, Prosopis, Eagle, and also Cassia, Acacia, Terminalia, two species, Plumbago, Raitia, Ampuria, Traca, Eurocrata, Sarcostema, Caparis, Spinosa, Gardenia, and Caloro carpus epigens are found to be under local threat, and they are going to be vulnerable, and in rare and also in short period they will be lost from their existence if not protected. And I have got analysis of the result. I have found that increase in the population has got its effect, and for 40 years that is the 4 census has been that is taken into consideration, where the population has increased from 8 lakhs to 15 lakhs, and that has caused the loss of biodiversity because of habitat destruction due to land use for different purposes. And I have this opinion suggestion for that, and to find the scientific base and the research and the development of the traditional knowledge and the conservation such as in situ and ex situ, and the conservation of sustainable and utilization of natural resources, and such as people biodiversity register may become a global moment in near future. These are the plants which are under which are used by the traditional knowledge, traditional healers. This plant that is Raitia arborea, it has got the traditional people, shepherd people use the latex to convert goat milk into curd within 10 minutes without adding butter milk.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Sudhir.